The glove box is located in the chemistry laboratory too. A glove box is an hermetic compartment with a controlled atmosphere that protects sensitive samples from humidity and oxygen. It allows you to work in overpression. It consists of an integrated neutral gas purification system, which ensures closed circuit purification of the gas atmosphere, argon, by eliminating oxygen and residual humidity. The achievable purities are of the order of 1 ppm in oxygen and water. Take care when using antechambers to never open both doors of the same chamber simultaneously. It is therefore advisable to visually check that the inner door is closed before opening the outer door and vice versa. Be careful not to open the outer door and inner door in succession without performing evacuation and filling up cycles. By default, the chambers must remain under vacuum. The glove box is supplied with 2 bottles of ultra pure argon gas with a pressure reduction of 3 to 4 bars. The glove box is equipped with a balance, a manual press, and handling utensils. You'll find a system for sealing your samples in argon gas in plastic bags. The glove box light switch is above right. By default, the chamber is under vacuum. You need to fill it up and return to atmospheric pressure, 0 on the needle pressure gauge, before opening the outer door. Use the panel screen to trigger the pump. Press manipulations section, then vacuum chambers, then gas filling. And finally press stop when atmospheric pressure is reached. Pressure gauge needle at 0. You can now open the outer door of the main chamber and enter the necessary equipment. Close the outer door of the main chamber and turn the handle. At the end, close with maximum 1/4 turn. Press vacuum chamber cycles and 2 vacuum and filling cycles will be performed automatically. This stage takes about 10 minutes. At the end of the chamber cycles, the panel screen returns to the home page. Put on the gloves. Remove rings and watches before entering the black box gloves to avoid piercing them. For everyone's hygiene, it is advisable to wear undergloves. Open the inner door and place the equipment in the glove box. Close this door. It is advisable to vacuum seal the main chamber, ensuring a tight seal between the inside and outside doors. Once the handling is complete, any equipment to be removed can be put back into the main chamber. If the main chamber is under vacuum, return it to atmospheric pressure, needle gauge to 0, so that the door can be opened. Introduce the items to be removed through the inner door. Close the door. At the end, close with maximum 1/4 turn. Carefully remove the gloves from the glove box. The chamber is quickly evacuated to ensure that the inner door is properly closed. Then carry out a quick refill before opening the outer chamber door. Remove the equipment or samples and close the door. Always evacuate the chamber after handling in the glove box or after removing or entering equipment. Press manipulations, vacuum chambers, main chamber, vacuum. Once the pressure displayed on the needle gauge is -1, press stop. Filling. Turn the valve on top of the small chamber 1/4 turn to the left to return chamber to atmospheric pressure. Gauge needle 0. Return the three-way valve to its position perpendicular to the chamber. Open the outer door of the small chamber by unscrewing the door anti-clockwise. Push the necessary equipment in the small chamber all the way down. Close the outer door. To create a vacuum in the small chamber, on a panel screen, press Manipulations section, then Vacuum Chambers, Mini Chamber Vacuum, then turn the three-way valve 1/4 turn to the right and remain in this position for 2 to 5 minutes. Gauge needle equals -1. Return the three-way valve to its position perpendicular to the chamber. To fill, turn the three-way valve 1/4 turn to the left. Return three-way valve to its position perpendicular to the mini chamber. Repeat these last operations at least 1 or 2 times. Stop the pump by pressing stop on the screen in the mini chamber section. Open the inner door of the small chamber to introduce the material into the glove box and then close it immediately. Vacuum the small chamber after any handling or entry or exit of equipment. Important: always keep the three-way valve in the middle position, perpendicular to the mini chamber, during operation and when you have completed all operations on this chamber. Once the handling is complete, any equipment to be removed can be put back into the mini chamber. If the mini chamber is under vacuum, return it to atmospheric pressure, needle gauge at 0, so that the door can be opened. Introduce the equipment or samples to be removed through the inner door. Close the door. The chamber is quickly evacuated to ensure that the inner door is properly closed. Then carry out a quick refill before opening the outer chamber door. Remove the equipment or samples and close the outer door. Always evacuate the chamber after handling in the glove box or after removing or inputting equipment. Press Manipulations, Vacuum Chambers, Mini Chamber and press Vacuum. Turn the three-way valve 1/4 turn to the right until a pressure of -1 is displayed on the needle pressure gauge. Return the three-way valve to its position perpendicular to the chamber. Press stop on the panel screen. Check that both chambers are under vacuum, pressure gauge needle below 0. Check the levels of the argon gas bottles. They should be replaced when they are below 20 bar. Check the oxygen and water levels on the control screen. If the oxygen level reaches 100, ensure that both chambers are under vacuum and contact the chemistry laboratory team as a matter of urgency.